Now, Emmerdale is shining a light on infertility at the moment. Earlier this year, Mandy Dingle revealed to her adoptive son that she can't conceive naturally. She swore him to secrecy, though, but tonight that secret comes out.
Chris, are you okay?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, no, it's just baby trouble.
Should I get the doctor?
No, it's nothing serious. It's just a bit of indigestion. Oh, my clothes just don't seem to fit properly, but I am not wearing maternity stuff yet.
Well, some people just be happy to be pregnant, but...
Yeah, I am too. I guess this just isn't my favourite part of it. But I'm sure it'll all feel great once I've got my baby. You OK?
Oh dear, Lisa. We want to go, hi, it's lovely to see you, but then we've been left on that note where she's so sad. Poor Mandy.
I know, we're going to open a big can of worms again tonight. That obviously hearing the trials and tribulations about the early stages of pregnancy, what Tracy was innocently talking about, it flags up the fact that obviously Mandy will never, ever be able to have children biologically herself because of the infertility. And as the episode goes on with the tears tonight, obviously Paul, unbeknownst to Mandy, will be hidden away, and he hears everything that Mandy actually would have had, you know, their child together. Yeah.
What did you think, Lisa, when you saw this storyline coming up for you from the scriptwriters?
I was so proud because infertility is not tackled in soap opera, and it really, really should be. And I got this overwhelming amount of response on social media once the lockdown episode was aired. And the volume of girls, Ruth, so young, and I had no idea. I'd done a little bit of research, you know, on infertility through operations, which is what we tackle in the show with Mandy Dingle. But it was the volume of girls. They were like 21, 27. And I couldn't believe the volume of girls so young and the pressure that they felt. And they felt that they could really open up to me. And I listened and I replied to everybody because they kept using the same word. They kept using the word, I feel incomplete. I don't feel like a woman. And the other side of the coin was that they get bombarded with people saying to them like, oh, well, why don't you adopt? Why don't you adopt? And they're like, I don't want to. I've took ownership of this and I'm happy. So for that reason, thank you to Emmerdale that we're bringing this story to the forefront, and it's going to go on for a long, long time, and we're going to see what happens and the repercussions that go with it.
And does it upset you, Lisa? You know, I'm just saying there, we were literally all a bit floored by that final shot of Mandy sitting there on the bench crying. Yeah. How difficult is that for you to deal with?
Well, I've openly discussed, you know, I've had a lot of trouble to conceive, and I've took ownership now that it's never going to happen for me and my Al, and that's fine. But if I can help other girls moving forward that are struggling, then long may that be the case.
So it resonates with you. I mean, you said there, people saying, oh, you know, why don't you adopt? Have you and Al had that happen to you? And how do you deal with that without looking sad or angry?
It's really, really hard because you kind of go, no, we're okay. And for whatever personal reasons that you have as a couple, you've spoken about it together and know that it won't happen to you, and it won't happen biologically, or if you wanted to adopt, or other elements. So I feel sometimes people need to have more awareness of how they you don't have to have those layers of the cake. If someone says, we don't have children, maybe just put a full stop there and go, oh, OK, fine, you know, so and then let them tell you.
So it must be great for you, Lisa, to be able to go back to Emmerdale and play this role to help the women out there that are struggling.
Unbelievably so, Coleen, because like I said, I had no idea. I mean, I'm 44, and it was the age groups that I couldn't understand, that, you know, these girls were having hysterectomies at 27 years old, 29. You know, that's young. That's really young. And also, they also feel that they can't start dating because a bloke won't go for them if they know they're infertile.
Lisa, I just watched that clip, and I think you play your character so beautifully, because I've been through infertility issues and I did go and adopt. But it's that loneliness, isn't it? It's when you're trying and nothing's happening. It's that loneliness that nobody really talks about.
I can't personally say that I've been lonely. You know, I've had Al, my family are phenomenal. I spoke openly about my family, let me be a big part with my niece and my nephews as well. And for Mandy, you know, she's the one, she feels very alone and she's kept it a secret. And we'll see tonight in the episode how she says to Vinny, do not tell anybody. She doesn't want to share it. She doesn't want to feel a burden. And as I said before, unfortunately though, Paul hears every single word that's
now, Lisa,
said.
Lisa, I really, really love working with you, but you've moved from London back to Yorkshire, haven't you?
Forgive me for that.
Why did you move away from me? I was taking it quite personally, but no, I'm not. I was only joking. What about your wedding? How are your wedding plans coming along?
I openly said, you know, lockdown was a time that if you're together for all those months and you don't kill each other, it's kind of the one you want to spend the rest of your life with. And I was like, you know, should we get married? And then we're like, no, it's like we already are. And now we just keep laughing about the new rules. Obviously, it was 30 guests and then it became 15 guests. And I'm like, this is bliss. Like, I've never... girl that wants a big white wedding and a tiara, you know. I've been married 3 times in pretend life. I certainly don't want that for me. And so the idea of just 15 guests, like my dad, his mum, like I said, my brother, my sister-in-law and the kids, simple 15 guests, you know, cheap and cheerful, just with the one you love.
Right,
that's
Lisa,
my
but
idea.
When is it going to happen? Have you set the date?
This storyline, Janet, it goes on till the end of March. Trust me. Look, how many scripts I've got today. This is me.
Right, so your wedding is... The date of your wedding will be decided by your storyline in Emmerdale.
That's pure pressure.
I noticed we weren't on that list, Lisa.
Yeah, right.
Yeah.
Well,
how are you going to fit all of us in?
No bridesmaid's role for me then, Lisa.
You as bridesmaid, what more does a girl want?
Can you imagine? But we'd all want to come, that's the problem. You can't just have one. If you have one, you have to have all of us. You know that, Lise, don't you?
Yeah.
We'll have to do it by Zoom or something.
Oh, yeah, we're Zoom bridesmaids.
Yeah, we're Zoom bridesmaids.
Lisa, always so lovely to see you. We miss you on Loose Women, but we know you're really happy back up in Leeds and we love watching you on Emmerdale and we shall continue to watch this story with Mandy, which, as Saira said, you're playing so brilliantly. Long may it continue. Love to see you, darling. See you soon.
Love you all.
Bye.
Oh, nice to see her, wasn't it? Yeah.